Hello everyone, I'm back and I am starting with a second layer. I'm starting with a gold glitter line in between the green and the gold glitter of Artisou. And I mixed a lot in the resin, as I always do, because then it doesn't flow to the side that much. Next, some clear over the crushed glass. And I'm adding some opal crystals, as I also did with the other gold leaf. So it dried very nice. I'm happy. And now I'm starting at the details and some things I want to try by layering some colors over each other. And I want to define some areas that I like. Now I'm adding some rhinestones, gold, to give it some sparkle. Now some clear over the green, because I want to try something. And I'm, what I always do, I'm pushing it with my steering stick against the white. And again, I speeded this video a little bit, not too much, but a little bit, because otherwise we had an hour of filming, and that's way too much. Little bit of heat to make it a little bit more liquid. And now I'm placing a line in the clear against the white over the top of the green. So first I have a layer of clear and then a white line on top of it. And now I'm heating it up again. And now I'm trying to blow the white over the green. But the green needs to show through, because I want to create some depth. And that it looks like the white is floating over the green. But I need to watch out again, because I don't want to burn my resin. So more clear, and also need to watch out because the glitter line is still wet. And I don't want them to flow too much in each other. It can flow to the inside, to the glitter gold of Artisou, but not to the green. So very carefully I'm placing some more clear against the glitter line. Some heat again. And again I'm trying to push the white over the green. Not too much because I want to see also see the green. It's a nice color. Now I'm filling in the caps with some clear. So the next color is Midnight Black of Lures. I make a line between the two black areas because I want to connect them. So a small line in between those parts. And also some against the black that I already have. I want it a little bit bigger. And also to define that area more. So next I'm placing a crust glass green around the green area. So on top of the white and the clear and the green. And with my steering stick, I place the crust glass where I want it. And it's also a barrier because I push it against the resin so that it stays where it is, so that it doesn't flow to the sides anymore. Then I have a kind of a dam. And also by placing the crushed glass, you define that area a little bit more. Straightening the line with my steering stick. So now some clear on the white against the chocolate gold of Lures, because I find the color very pretty, but it's too much. Again, some heat. And what I also did in the green, also here a white line, so that I can blow the white over the chocolate gold. Not too much, because I want to still see the chocolate gold more clear. I'm pushing it against the green. And again, some heat to blend the color in the clear. Now a glitter line against the black. I love glitter, so there needs to be a lot of glitter in this painting. Again, some clear, because I missed some spots. A little bit of heat for the air bubbles. So the last thing I'm going to do is some green glitter over the crushed glass. Then I'm going to wait for 4 hours. And after 4 hours, I can place the next colors on the canvas. So we are 4 hours later. It dried. It's not almost. It's almost dry. So not fully cured, but I can place the next colors on the canvas. So I'm starting with some clear, because what I have on the other side over the chocolate gold, I want also over this part. Then it balances the painting. Heating it again to make it a liquid. And now again a white line in the clear, because I want the same effect as I have with the other chocolate gold. More clear. A little bit more white, I didn't have enough, and then we're going to heat again and trying to blow the white over the chocolate gold. Now I'm placing some crushed clean green glass against the chocolate gold and on the green color. I push it against the resin. And what I already told you, it's like a dam. So the last crushed glass on the canvas. Now to the other side, also in the green, some crushed glass. First some clear. And then on top of it, the crushed glass. I put a lot on, I like that. Gives a nice structure. And what I already told you is that you need a lot of patience with this kind of resin paintings. And especially when it's a large one. Because I can't do a whole layer in one go. because I have only a working time of 30 to 45 minutes, and yeah, I can't do a canvas of 60 by 80 centimeters in 30 to 45 minutes. Not in the way I do it. So I'm doing it in several parts, but it doesn't matter. I like it this way. Little bit of clear on top. So the next color is the glitter gold of Artisou. I had that part first white, but I think it doesn't match the canvas, the colors. I wanted glitter gold. I think that balances the painting more. On the other side, a little bit of clear over the glitter gold. And I'm placing some crushed glass white. And also on the other side, the crushed glass white. Now a little bit of black, because I made that line, but I don't like it. It needs to be a little bit wider. So I'm placing some midnight black against it. And it's not straight enough, it needs to be straighter. So that's why I'm placing that black. And also a black line around the glitter. Because I want to outline that part. And also there is a white spot that I don't like, so I'm placing some black over it. Still not satisfied with my black line there. Again a glitter line against the black and in the glitter gold. All around it. So you can see again, I mixed a lot of glitter in the resin. Then it gets much thicker, and you can place it with a stirring stick on your canvas. Also on the other side in the green. And also on the other side against the black, some glitter. So the last bit of heat for the air bubbles. This was part 4. And in part 5 I'm going to place some acrylic lines and maybe some fire glass, I don't know, but we will see. Now to the close-up. So this is the close-up. First the overall look and then a close-up of the glitter lines, the crushed glass, the white that I blowed over the chocolate gold. Looks very nice, it looks 3D. I'm very happy with it. A lot of glitter. What I have till now, so far, I'm happy with it. So what I just said in step 5, maybe some acrylic lines, I don't know yet, need to think about it. Or some fire glass to make it even more sparkly. Again the white over the green. So if you like my videos, please subscribe to my channel. If you want to place a comment or do you have tips, say so, place it under the video. Or do you have questions, also ask me, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.